Hello students, welcome to the GATE Academy. Myself, Murali Krishna, I have total 4 years of teaching experience and I'm going to teach that power electronics, electrical machines and control systems. In this video, I'm going to share a few ideas about how to prepare for the technical interview in a respective PSU. But before that, first of all, I would like to congratulate each and everyone who got shortlisted for the respective PSUs. Now, in any PSU, the selection process is basically, there are three stages. The first stage is based upon your GATE score or GATE rank, they will shortlist. That is already have done. Now, coming to the second stage is, there will be a personal interview as well as a group discussion or a group task and a technical interview. Now, if you want to know about that, how to prepare for the group discussion as well as a group task, in this below the video, you will find one link. If you go through that link, definitely you will get a clear-cut clarity about how to prepare for the GD as well as the group task. So, after entering into the technical panel, you have to follow certain important things in that particular interview. The first and foremost thing is, you have the knowledge about the PSU. Whether you go to BARC or whether you go to DRDO or ISRO or any IOCL, first of all, you have to get at least a minimum knowledge on a particular PSU. Now, the next important point is brush up your technical skills, brush up your technical knowledge and technical concepts. And the next one is selection of subjects. It means at least you have to prepare 3 to 5 subjects which are very important for you and which are very comfortable for you. And at least you have to take 3 to 5 subjects, and the selection of subject is very, very important in this particular technical interview. And the last but not least is be prepared for that tricky questions. Tricky questions are nothing but you cannot expect like very difficult questions. They are only very practical based questions. Okay. So if you follow these 4 steps, your interview is going to be very well. So now let us see the tips for a PSU interview. So what are the questions you have to prepare and what kind of questions generally they will ask commonly for all the branches, how they will ask commonly. Let us see one by one. The first thing is, tell me about yourself. This is a very common question in each and every interview, in each and every PSU interview. But in this interview, some changes will be there. Like, tell me about yourself, which is not represented in your resume, which is not reflected in your resume. It means you have to kept aside a few things, that what are the things you are not mentioned in that particular resume, then you have to recall that particular terms. Okay. And the next one is, why would you like to join in our company? This is one of the important question in that. So you have to be very careful about why we are going to join in that particular company. You have to be very careful about that particular answer. Now, the next one is, why we should hire you? This is a very common question asking in every engineering services or every public sectors, in every interview also. This is the most important question. And the next one is, what do you know about our company? I told you already, before going to entering into the panel, you have to follow certain things in that. The second one is, at least you have to know about the company, PSU, before going to enter into the PSU. At least you have to know what is the, for example, if you consider any Power Grid Corporation of India Limited, PGCIL. So if you're going for that particular interview, you have to focus on what is the transmission capacity, what is the distribution capacity. At least you have to know the distribution capacity in your particular state and what is your nearest power grid. So for that grid, what is the distribution capacity? What is the transmission capacity? You have to be analyzed before going to the particular company. And the next one is, what is your contribution in your final year project? See, be prepared well for your final year BTEC project. This is a very, very important question which is commonly asked. So what are the contribution you have done? So what are the implementations you have done in the project? And what is the portion of your project you have contributed? And answer this question in an effective manner so that the interview panel must be impressed. And the next one is, why not MBA or MTech? Why are you choosing only PSU? So be ready for this question with your proper answer, right? Be ready with this question, why PSU? Why not MBA or MTech? Okay. And the next question is, what are your favorite subjects of interest? This is the very, very crucial part in your technical interview. So once if you go through this question, please be answer only the subjects which you are very familiar. At least I told you 3 to 5 subjects you have to prepare. Minimum 3 subjects you have to prepare. So the selection of subjects should be based upon your comfortable. It means how much you are confident in that subject. And that too, that subject should be in a descending order. For example, if you are very well about power systems, but you are not much confident on controls, but it is comfortable little bit, but not better than power systems, but control systems also you are comfortable. Like that, then you have to put your first preference as a power system, second preference as a control systems, and then so on so subjects. It depends on your descending order. How much effectively you are confident on your particular subject, you have to be present according to that deciding order. Suppose if you are consider any power electronic subject, if you are thinking that if you are confident on this, put it on the first. If you are not comfortable, but at least you know the little bit knowledge about that particular subject, put it in the last. So based on that hierarchy, you have to give to that respective subjects. So from now onwards, your interview is going to start. The technical interview is going to start. So what they have asked, they will give you a piece of paper. They will ask you write down your 3 to 5 important subjects. But it is not applicable for each and every PSU. It will vary from PSU to PSU. Now regarding the group discussion and the group task, if you want to know the more information, below this video there will be a link. If you go through that link, so you will get a clear-cut idea about how to prepare for group task and group discussion. Now, in this video, I'm gonna take about around 8 to 9 PSUs. So how they are asking the questions and what kind of subjects of interest you have to choose and what kind of subjects they are going to mostly concentrate, it is varies from PSU to PSU. Let us see in detail one by one. Let us see the first one. BARC, Bhabha Atomic Research Center. This is one of the most top PSU. So in this particular technical interview, that too in this particular PSU, there will be a interview panel committee of around 5 to 6 people will be there. Around 5 to 6 people will be there. So in this particular interview, the first thing they will do is they will give you a piece of paper and they will ask you to write down your favorite 3 to 5 subjects, and at least 5 subjects you have to write. So based upon, I told you already, based upon of your confidence on the particular subject, please write down that particular subject in a descending order. This is a very, very important, right? And this is the one of the most longest duration interview. It means it is at least a minimum 50 minutes will be there. At least if your interview is going on good, so definitely your interview is going to be long, about more than 50 minutes. Basically, they will concentrate on these few subjects mostly. Let us see one by one. That is, first one is analog electronics. In this analog electronics, they will focus on the rectifier operation and the clippers and the clampers. They will ask very, very basic questions first. So after that, they will linking with this analog electronics or any other particular subject which they have start, they will interlink with the next subject. And one more thing, control systems. And control systems is also one of the major subject which is opted by any PSU for interview perspective. They will concentrate definitely control systems, and particularly in control systems, they will ask controllers. PID controllers. Please be prepared in any PSU in control system, mostly P controller, it means compensators and controllers. You have to prepare well about these controllers. Very well, very, very important this topic. And coming to the next one is network, basic network theory. So just focus on how to apply the nodal analysis and mesh analysis, what is the importance of the mesh analysis, why we opt mesh analysis over nodal or nodal over mesh. If they ask any such kind of tricky questions, you have to be ready with the basics of electrical network subject. And moreover, I told you already, this is the interview which is going in a very long manner. It is a very longer duration. So if you are there in that particular panel for a long duration of time, it means provided your interview is going to be good. So definitely there will be a lot of chances to go to be selected. So if you are about, for example, if the interview is going to be conducted from more than 50 minutes, so definitely you should be there, at least minimum 50 minutes should be there. If you beyond the 50 minutes, there will be a lot of chances are going to be selected in this particular interview. And the last but not least is, I told you, please select, always I'm suggesting you that please select the subjects in a decreasing order. Please don't be confused, and while going to the interview, select at least 3 to 4 subjects minimum, maximum 5 subjects enough. So minimum 3 to 4 subjects you have to prepare, and the selection of subjects in a decreasing order. Don't forget that. Now let us see the next PSU. And the next PSU is DRDO. So DRDO means Defense Research and Development Organization. So in this interview panel, around 6 to 7 members will be there. So there is a two possibilities in this interview. The first one is either they will give a chance to you to select your interest of the subjects, or otherwise they will take according to their wish. So based upon that, they are asking the questions based on only four subjects which are mostly concentrated. The first one is control systems. In this control systems, they are asking very basic questions, and that too, as I earlierly mentioned, that you have to be ready with controllers. PI controller, PID controller and PD controller, very 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 important topic this is. So in any research organization, this is one of the key tool in control systems. And the next one is power electronics. So in this power electronics, they will ask more in depth about thyristor and as well as converters also. So be ready with the thyristor concepts, like if you take any fully controlled converter or three phase controlled converter, and as well as the working of the SCR. This is a very very important. Or else generally they will ask a question, how can you say that SCR is a positive feedback device? SCR is a positive feedback device. Then you have to answer that. Whether if you know that answer, please be answer it is in a confident manner. If you don't know, please don't try to bluff them. Just simply you can say that whether I'm not recalling at this moment, like that you have to answer. And then the next one is electrical machines. So in this electrical machines, they're mostly concentrating on induction motor as well as a transformer. So be prepared, at least induction motor and a transformer working, and its characteristics are very very important. So based upon your this selection of topics in induction motor and transformers, your interview is going to be effectively varies. And the last one is the power systems. So in power systems, mostly they will concentrate on circuit breakers as well as the transmission and distribution. So try to focus on a protection scheme. Mostly in any interview if you choose any interview, the protection scheme is always very very important in a power systems concept. If they ask any question in a power systems, the first and foremost thing, if they want to start as, they will choose only protection scheme. After that, distribution or a transmission capacity, like that they will start. So now let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is BHEL, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited. So this is a manufacturing company. This is an electrical machinery manufacturing company. So in this interview panel, there will be at least 5 to 6 members will be there. So they will ask you, the questions are like, what is your BTech project? So I told you already, please try to prepare thoroughly at least your BTech project, like what is your contribution at least in that, and brush up your BTech project. This is a very very important, and the first and foremost question they will ask in BHEL. And the next one is, as I told you already, it is a manufacturing company. If it is a manufacturing company, means definitely you have to be focused on at least two to three machineries, like induction motor, synchronous machine or a transformers. It is a very very popular, well known manufacturing company. So at least you have to focus on, at least you have to focus on the induction motor or a transformer or synchronous machine. At least you have to do two to three machines, you have to be concentrate. Next one is Next one is related to the power plant, like for example boiler efficiency and pumps and types of turbine, like Kaplan turbine, propylene turbine, like that. They will ask just a basic information. If you belong to the electrical department, then they will not go in depth about the turbine analysis, but they will go in depth about your machines like transformers, induction motor and synchronous machine, as well as a DC motor. So be prepared. As earlier mentioned that it is a manufacturing company, so be prepared for the electrical machine subject more in this. If you prepare electrical subject like machines more, so you can easily get into this particular interview. Easily you can crack this interview. Let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is PGCIL, Power Grid Corporation of India Limited. So this is the one of the most popular public sector, and this is the only PSU offering a huge package around 15 lakhs per annum, on an average 15 lakhs per annum. So in this interview panel, there will be at least 5 to 6 people will be there. At least 5 to 6 people will be there minimum. And the interview comprises of, mostly they will concentrate on power systems. So as I earlier mentioned that it is a Power Grid Corporation of India Limited. So they will mostly focus on this transmission and distribution, and as well as the generating capacity. So at least you have to know basics of your, in your particular state, what is the distribution capacity and what is your state is getting supply from which grid. So what is its generating capacity? What is its distribution capacity? At least you have to know all these basics. So if you go to any power transmission companies like public sector, like Power Grid Corporation of India Limited, like NTPC, if you go to NHPC, if you go through this particular interview, must and should you have to have at least a minimum knowledge on power systems, so that it will be really helpful. Mostly focus on, I told you already, protection scheme is very, very important, as well as transmission and distribution. So try to focus on these areas, as well as try to focus on little bit about electrical machines also. They will ask in electrical machines that about synchronous machines mostly. So please be prepared about electrical machines as well as the power systems, but concentrate on mostly on power systems. And let us see, in electrical machines, concentrate more on transformers as well as the synchronous machines. So if you focus on this particular area, your technical interview is going to be little bit easier. Now let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation of India Limited. So this is also a power transmission company. So in this also, they will mostly focus on that particular transmission subjects, like for example power systems and switchgear and production. These are very, very important in this particular interview. So mostly they will stress on switchgear and production. And the next one is electrical machines. In that electrical machines also, they will focus on synchronous machines as well as the transformers. So be prepared well about synchronous machines and transformers. The selection of machines is also very, very important. Out of 4 machines, you have a DC machine, induction machine, transformer and synchronous. The selection of subject will be based on the interview. Suppose if you are going to any NTPC or a power grid, definitely you have to prepare that synchronous machines as well as the transformers, because those two are very, very important machines in your any transmission and distribution level. Now the next subject is a power electronics. So in this power electronics, they will not go in depth, but they will ask only the basics, like how SCR is working, why we are not using GTO even though gate turn off process is available, so but still we are using SCRs. What is the disadvantage of SCR with respect to inverters, with respect to choppers? So you have to be ready with the very, very basic questions. They will not go very in depth. They will ask only very, very basic questions, and the interview is about just 15 to 20 minutes only. So within this 20 minutes, you have to be ready with these 3 subjects. Mostly they are focusing on these 3 only. So if you go through these 3, definitely it will be helpful for your technical interview. Now let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is IOCL, Indian Oil Corporation of India Limited. So as you have seen that it is a refinery based company. So before going to this particularly any refinery companies, any oil companies, before going to that particular interview, try to get awareness of any your nearest refineries. For example, if you consider Reliance, so go through about that Reliance, at least one refinery you have to consider. One refinery you have to consider. In this particular interview, definitely they will ask the basics of refinery, and at least they will ask one question from the Reliance. Definitely they will ask one question from the Reliance company. So at least go through the Reliance company so that you will get a certain information related to that any refinery based questions. And the next one is, they will concentrate on the following subjects. The first one is control systems, power systems and electrical machines. So in control systems, they will ask only the basic questions like what is a control system and why we are using the negative feedback, what is the importance of the negative feedback, and tell me what are the basic controllers we are using in control systems, what are the types of controllers. So try to focus mostly on controllers as well as in compensators. Try to focus at least on that. And the next one is power systems. So in power systems, they will not much go in depth, but they will ask at least what is the transmission capacity or what is the distribution capacity, or else they will ask, as I earlier mentioned, that protection scheme. In every interview, at least they will touch one power system question. Definitely they will touch. So the next subject is electrical machines. Let us see, if you consider about electrical machines, even though it is an oil based company, you are expecting that they may not ask questions from electrical machines. But don't think like that. There may be a chance of asking a questions from the electrical machines also, because in the interview panel, definitely there will be a minimum 5 to 6 people will be there. So there may be definitely person belongs to any IIT or any chairperson. So definitely you have to ready with this questions. And let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is ONGC. It is a natural gas based company. So before going to get into this interview, please try to prepare at least one gas based company information related to that. So how the generation is happening, how the distribution is happening. Please go through once so that it will be helpful for you. And they will stress only on a few subjects like control systems and electrical machines. As I really mentioned that control systems will definitely have to consider only compensators and controllers. These are very, very most important. And coming to that electrical machines, they will concentrate on very basic questions of transformers and induction motor. Try to focus on transformers and induction motor. Mostly you will experience the questions from these two concepts only. And the interview is about exactly 15 to 20 minutes. So within this 15 to 20 minutes, they may ask more questions related to your personal or may not. But definitely interview questions like technical related questions, minimum 5 to 10 minutes will be there. So within 5 to 10 minutes, either they ask from control systems or electrical machines, at least they will touch the refinery based, like gas based company. So that your interview panel is going to be around 50 to 20 minutes. So during that particular time, please try to focus on the subjects and please be answered effectively. Now let us see the next PSU, that is NPCIL, Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. This is also one of the most popular PSU. So in this interview panel, there will be a 6 to 7 members will be there. So be ready with the following subjects. Those are very, very important in this particular interview. So the first thing is analog electronics. In that particular analog electronics, they will ask about op amp. Operational amplifier they will touch definitely. They will ask about operational amplifier, and before that they may start with what is meant by a rectifier, or what is meant by a clipper, what is meant by a clamper. So be aware of that, and must you have to prepare op amp. Okay, and the next subject is networks. So the networks is a very, very basic level. So basic level questions they will ask, like what is meant by mesh analysis, what is meant by nodal analysis, how the transients will occur, what is the two-port network, what is the importance of the two-port network, example, what is the best example of a two-port network. So you have to be just analyze only basic level questions. The next subject is the basics of physics. So they will ask only very basic questions on the basics of physics. So Don't worry about this much, but try to focus on at least the basics of your physics. And the next one is, they will ask in control systems. As I told you already, control systems is the common part in any public sector. Definitely you will experience a question from a control systems. So mostly they will ask controllers only. So what kind of controllers you are going to prepare? PI, PD and PID controllers. This is a very, very important. Again, I am stressing this point. If you go to any interview, definitely they will ask control system based question. Definitely you will experience at least one question from any controller. Definitely. So try to prepare about control systems. Now let us see the next PSU. The next PSU is NHPC, National Hydropower Corporation of India Limited. So in this interview panel, there will be a committee of 6 to 7 members will be there. And the interview is a purely technical, and the technical interview contains only 2 subjects, 2 to 3 subjects only. Majorly they will concentrate on power systems as well as electrical machines. So in this interview, in particularly power system subject, you have to concentrate mostly on transmission. What is the transmission level? What is the latest transmission level? What is the latest distribution level in your state? So what is the latest transmission capacity of a particular power grid? So you have to be very, very careful about the transmission and distribution levels, and little bit knowledge about the circuit breaker. That is also very, very important. And coming to the electrical machine, as I earlierly mentioned that if you go to any transmission based company, in any distribution based company, they will definitely suggest you, and they will definitely ask you either power systems or electrical machines or both. If they ask any question from power system, definitely they will ask from transmission and distribution as well as the switchgear and protection. Just the basics of circuit breaker, how the relay will work, what is the use of CT, what is the use of PT, potential transformer and current transformer, they will ask. For example, in electrical machines, if they ask any question, definitely they will touch transformers as well as a synchronous machine. Try to focus on these two subjects mostly if you go to any power transmission companies. So I'm telling you that till now you have seen lot many PSUs. So there are so many PSUs are there, but these are the major PSUs you are going to concentrate, and you have to concentrate for any public sector. But remember one thing, if you observe that from beginning BARC to now NHPC, the common subjects, remember, the common subjects are, they are asking control systems, power systems and electrical machines. If you prepare these three subjects thoroughly, power systems is a very big subject, but don't bother about that. Just to know the basics of transmission and distribution or generation, and basics of circuit breaker working and relay working, and a protection scheme. What is a protection scheme employing for a transformer, for a synchronous generator? So you have to be at least have these kind of basic questions on power systems. In electrical machines, most of the questions are asking only either induction motor, transformer or synchronous machine. So try to prepare at least induction motor and transformer completely. Completely induction motor and transformer, just brush up about synchronous machine. Now coming to the control systems, they will ask about the basics of control systems, about what is meant by control system, examples of open loop and closed loop systems in practical, and what is meant by the feedback, what is the use of negative feedback, what is the effect of positive feedback, so what is the stability of the system, and compensators and controllers are very, very, very important. So if you concentrate on these three subjects mostly, then go for at least remaining two subjects. The selection of remaining two subjects at least should be, one should be power electronics, another one should be networks, because control systems and power electronics are nowadays a leading any research applications. So definitely they will stretch these two subjects. But if you go to any power transmission company, you have to mostly concentrate on power systems and electrical machines. Okay, so this is all about a few PSUs I have considered to share a few ideas about how to attempt a technical interview. I hope you like this video and keep watching, and all the best. Thank you.